today is my first day of clinical rotations, and I'm so excited to start. So my first rotation is neurology.
I don't think this is how this surgery actually goes.
In our school, our neurology rotation is 4 weeks long, and I finished it last week. This week, I'm currently on our psychiatry rotation, but I'm coming out with a video about that later on.
My night shift is over.
And this week, I'm in a new block of my internal medicine rotation, cardiology.
Class 1B.
All right, so today was awesome because we got let out at 3 p.m. But these last 2 weeks, I'm on the leukemia service before my shelf exam, which is next Friday.
It has a lot of meaning to me.
So I quit medical school.
And I'm a current third year medical student on a 1 year leave of absence. Now, this decision was extremely difficult to make, and there was a lot of things I was considering before making this decision. And this video, it's a little bit hard to make, you know. I don't know how to approach this subject. And I want to share with you all like why I made this decision and my plans moving forward. But I want to be honest with you all and let you know that. Taking a leave of absence was a difficult decision at the time. I was so worried about how this would make me look, what would residency programs think of me, how could I justify this after all the hard work I put in. Looking back, this was one of the most crucial and beneficial decisions I've made in medical school. My whole life has been one giant educational ladder, always preparing for the next test, the next exam to prove my worth. Having the time to focus on myself and other opportunities was a blessing. It gave me a newfound perspective that I desperately needed. We're all in our own timeline and our journeys cannot always be linear. No matter what stage you are, always take the time to reflect on your own progress, to put in some effort on your own health, and most importantly, to be creative. Because I'm well aware of how stifling medical school can be towards what makes us who we are.
And if it's true, I will surrender and give life to our world that's our own.
I've never had banana milk, like, in the boba.
She looked kind of funny.
Not every day your son winning the state championship.
Очень довольна, что мы приехали в эту страну, и она нам дала такие возможности.
¿Qué pasa, mi Nakama? My name is Daniel, and here's one last adventure before medical school. Bienvenidos a Colombia.
What is up, my Nakama? My name is Daniel. I'm a current third year medical student. Man, it's been so long since I've made a vlog like this. I am officially going back to medical school. I actually have medical school responsibilities today. So we're on our thing called transition to patient care, which I actually did last year, so I don't have to do all the events, but it's kind of a transition into clinical rotations. There's a bunch of modules and stuff, but I am I was on gynecology and oncology, and it was just really tough overall.
It's all about finding that balance again.
I think the magic is when you find something you just love to do and are very passionate about.
Like, exercise was fun, and it was a hobby, and it like became part of like who I am.
Medical school sucks sometimes. It's hard. It's not always the best time. Sometimes you wish you see other people living life now. I live on loans perpetually, and I'm like, when am I gonna earn money? But it's like, you're doing this because it's so worth it. But my mom always tells me, you know, my mom is so annoying because she's always right. What my mom always tells me is like, when you're struggling with it, just find the joy in it and make it fun. Don't even think about the work.
Because I think the number one skill that folks in medical school or undergrad can really have that will be able to help them for the rest of their financial lives is learning how to budget, learning how to stick to a budget, and being able to maximize, you know, the fun and the amount that you can get for the dollar that you spend.
Thank you. the invitation. You got the right address. You need some medication. The answer's always yes. A little chance encounter could be the one you've waited for. Just squeeze a bit more. Tonight we're on a mission. Tonight's the casting call. If this is the real audition,
oh God, help us all.
You make the right impression, then everybody knows your name. We're in the fast lane. Someone in the crowd could be the one you need to know. The one to finally lift you off the ground. Someone in the crowd could take you where you wanna go.
So I show up at 5:45 a.m. and I don't even like have time to introduce myself to the resident. He just straight up yeets me, tells me to gown up, glove up, and head straight to the OR for a C-section because one of his patients that he'd been taking care of, he wanted to do the C-section himself. And I showed up and he like had no time to do any introductions. He's just like, all right, you're coming in with me. You're assisting with this procedure. Basically back to back to back traumas was tonight. Gunshot wounds, motorcycle accidents, falls, anything and everything you can think of. I don't know what to expect. It's in the pediatric ED, but we're gonna have a good time. It's gonna be great. I'm gonna learn a lot, and I'll let you know how it goes after my shift. Dattebayo.
Today's forecast, a lot of sunshine, blue skies, marine clouds. Just the perfect day to go outside and relax. That's your forecast. Right back. Yeah, sunny day, sunny day, sunny day. No clouds in the sky, but I get away. Feels like it's been a freaking decade. Sorry, don't call me, cause I'm gonna be a great day.
So, here's how it went down.
New York City. So much to do and so much to see around every corner. I just love it so much because you can go anywhere and everywhere and have a really good time.
What's your rating, AJ?
10.
And because family medicine is kind of a chill rotation, I decided to take you along for a day on family medicine.
Burnout is a tricky subject because I don't think we fully understand it until the aftermath.
And, you know, it was definitely a profound kind of shift from being a bratty preteen who was upset that I couldn't play basketball anymore to realizing that, you know, the kid next to me was fighting for his life. So that shifted my whole viewpoint and kind of put me on the path towards medicine.
After 2.5 years, oh man, after 2.5 years, it's finally happened. I got COVID. Get comfy.
The moment of truth.
I studied, tried to work out, did a lot of self-care, watched a lot of anime and K-dramas, and overall had a good time.
Just got out of clinic. It is raining outside. It's 1 p.m. right now, so it was kind of a long clinic, but I did a ton of stuff and I think I did really well. And the attending said I was a huge help in terms of like running things efficiently this morning.
What is up, my Nakama? My name is Daniel. I'm a current third year medical student, and this is my last rotation of my third year of medical school. I'm on my pediatrics rotation, and specifically, I'm on my inpatient pediatrics.
Alright friends, so just got back from day two of inpatient peds. Once again, rounds lasted until 2, so I had lunch at around 2:30.
No.
Alright, my Nakama, today is officially my last day of pediatric inpatient medicine. Actually, my last day of inpatient ever as a third year medical student.
Hey, I'm Hannah. I'm a fourth year med student applying to anesthesia, and this is the Bluebird Day School Week.